What's up, guys, and welcome back to All About the Popcorn. I'm Stephanie. Thank you for clicking on this video. Now, if you're someone who enjoys talking about film, consider hitting that subscribe button. So today we're going to be talking about Netflix's newest animated film, Vivo. Collaboration between Sony Pictures and Netflix have not let us down so far. We did, of course, get The Mitchells vs. the Machines earlier in the year, which is one of my favorite movies of 2021 so far. I just absolutely loved it. Now, this is actually a movie that Lin-Manuel Miranda did pitch to DreamWorks back in like 2010. I think that's where I heard it from. But unfortunately, of course, as you can tell, they passed on the opportunity. Sony Pictures did end up picking it up. This is one of the films that was supposed to have a 2020 theatrical release, but of course, like all the movies in 2020, because of the pandemic, did get pushed back, and it did ultimately get sold to Netflix, and now it is available for you to stream at home. Now, Lin-Manuel Miranda did actually help write most of the songs, and of course, has been killing it these last few years with Hamilton to In the Heights. Now we have Vivo. He is literally coming through with the Latin American representation. Now, this is an animated musical, so if you're not really into musicals, then this is not really going to be for you. But if you do enjoy musicals, as I do, then your ears will be in for a very, very, very good treat. And then we do start off the movie in Cuba. We meet Andres. We meet his very beloved musical monkey, or rather, Kinkachu. It's a very cute little monkey. I don't know where you got kind of monkey. Kinkachu, I think that's how you say it. They say it throughout the whole damn movie, you guys, and I still don't know how to say it properly. Either way it goes. They are street performers. They are living their best life. We do start off the movie straight off the bat with a musical number. So again, if you're not into musicals, this is not going to be for you. Vivo does bust out into a rap song, and it just doesn't go with it. You know, like, I get Lin-Manuel is trying to show us that he can rap, which we already know from Hamilton. I don't really feel like it's something he needs to put into all his movies. And I guess it's just something he wants to showcase. I get it, man. But there's certain movies, there's certain things that it doesn't really belong or doesn't really mesh very well in. The voice cast is great. Like I said, we have Lin-Manuel Miranda, we have Zoe Saldana. She does play Gabby's mom. And then we also get Gloria Estefan. She plays Marta. She's pretty much the love that got away from Andres. Honestly, when I was seeing her, she was giving me Celia Cruz vibes. I mean, it wasn't like major, which is like a little bit of it. I was just like, I'm so glad. They do have some amazing songs here. I loved it. My favorite song would be the one that we finally hear there at the end, the one that Andres wrote for Marta, Inside Your Heart. I think that's what it's called, you guys. I actually teared. No, I didn't tear up. I had some tears coming down. The movie actually made me cry, you guys. I got really emotional. It does have like a little like emotional factor to it. So if you are a crier, if you are an emotional person like me that cries in everything, not everything, you guys, but I do cry in like 90% of things. And of course, Gabby's song that we do hear earlier on in the movie, and we do hear it right as soon as the credits hit, marching to the beat of your own drum. I can carry a beat. I'm like Gabby, I can carry a damn beat to save my damn life. But that one was actually really, really fun. Gabby's character just is so unique. She's just the weird kid, you know. She's the one that doesn't want to be in the Girl Scouts. She wants to play her instruments and sing and do very artsy kind of things. The villain in the movie, because you know there's always a villain, but technically there's really actually no villain here. It's basically the Girl Scouts, but again, they're really not villains. They're just really trying to capture Vivo just to quarantine him. It's really just safety precaution. They're very like environmentalist, which it does of course have that message within the movie for the kids about the environment. Again, they're not really villains. They're really just trying to be safe. But even though with all those positives, you guys, because there is a lot of positives, even though it did get me like all types of emotional, unfortunately, as a whole, as the story actually goes, the story itself is not the best. There's just just certain things in the movie, you guys, that just don't really work very well. But it's things that I guess in the long run, you can just kind of look past it. Of course, the kids are going to enjoy it. The whole family, honestly, will enjoy this. Again, if you are into musicals, because if you're not, then it's not going to be for you. Before I do give you my score, if you haven't already, don't forget to give this video a like. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. Don't forget to hit the notification bell so you'll be notified each time that I post something new. Animation, again, is absolutely beautiful. The songs are very catchy, you guys. The songs are very catchy. I think it's like a nice little soundtrack to have like at work. I'm not gonna lie, if it wasn't for the story, I would have given it a large popcorn. But unfortunately, because of the story, because obviously what makes up the movie, it is going to get a medium popcorn. If you've seen Vivo, let me know down below, what did you think about it? Did you like it? Did you love it? Did you hate it? Was it just not for you? If you haven't seen it already, is it something that you're maybe now looking forward to checking out? Or just musicals not your thing and you're like, nope, that's just not for me? Once again, you can find Vivo currently on Netflix. All right, guys, until next time, I'll see you guys at concessions. Bye.